Hi friends, it's Tracy from the Financial Freedom Diary, and today we're back to do my week 3 check-in for the month of November. This is the check-in for my cash envelopes. If you're new to my channel, please consider subscribing below, and thank you all for supporting me, watching my videos. I appreciate each and every last one of you oh so much. So, before we get started with our transactions, my thumb on my right hand is going to be looking janky, but I broke my fingernail Thursday. I was supposed to have put a band-aid on, totally forgot. So I'm sorry, but yeah, broke down in the nail bed. So it's kind of janky looking, but there's neither here nor there. I did get some happy mail and their Thanksgiving cards. And I believe this one's a birthday card. And it's so cute. Look at all that bedazzle and razzmatazz. That's my jam. Mm-hmm. And y'all know I love pink. So this one says, a good life is measured by more than just candles on a cake. It's so sweet. I can't tell y'all what's on the inside because it's going to make me cry. But yeah, it's super, super sweet. And I love this one. I just love it, love it, love it. I can't go into the Hallmark store anymore, so... I banished myself. And then there's this one, which was a Thanksgiving one, and I think it's super cute. I'm one of these people, because at first I read it and I started cackling, because you know I do this before I go to events where that people have. I want to know what's going to be on the menu, what did they prepare it in and stuff like that. And the reason why is because I have allergies. And so, like, I'm allergic to pecans, I'm allergic to almonds, I'm allergic to, like, bananas. There's certain things that they make me itch like crazy, so I need to know all these things. Now, my friends, they know how I am, and they tell me ahead of time. Like, oh, we're having this, and you can have this, 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 and this. And I'll make sure I point it out so you know what to grab from. But, yeah, I'm one of these people. So, I don't know how people feel about it, but, you know, I don't wait till I get to the table. I want to know before the event so I know what the menu is. Do I need to eat before I go? You know, I have to have my plan already set up. But, yeah, this one made me chuckle because I'm like, is a turkey keto-friendly? I hollered at that one. I'm like, I thought all meat was keto-friendly, but I don't know much about keto. And I would... have a hard time if I had a vegan friend. Is this pumpkin pie organic? Does it matter? It's pie. Just eat it. But I thought that was super cute. But thank you so much, Miss Brenda. I love them both. That was so cute. But yeah. Okay. Let me calm down. Because y'all know I love cards. So I got to go put them in their place over my desk, so when I'm dealing with the grumpies at work, I don't turn into a grumpy myself, and I can get a little kiki while I work. So, alrighty, now to my transactions. Laundry. I spent $15, but that was because when I went out and looked at what my oldest son had, it was all his winter gear, so I guess he's pulling everything out, so I washed all of that. And then at Walmart and household, I spent $7.33. And at Walmart and groceries, I spent $19.04. And then at Aldi's and groceries, I spent $35.97. I'm trying to remember what I spent for, you know, like what I bought with household. I honestly don't remember. Whatever it was, I must have needed it because it's just not sticking out to me. I did find that thing you guys told me to help unstop my sink. And so, thank you for that, because I did find that it wasn't a clog like in the drain itself. It was around the stopper. You know, the little stopper thing. So, I pulled that thing out. And it just had like hard soap all stuck up in the little grooves and stuff. So I cleaned all that stuff out. But that's gross. It was a little bit freaky. touching it, digging it out, and you know, luckily, but I was wearing gloves. But it was, a lot more work than what I thought. But I guess it's better than pouring Drano down there, because that didn't work. So in laundry, I spent $15, and I ended week two with $45. I spent $15, so I should have $30 left. So let's check in the wallet before I get myself distracted. So 20, 25, 30. Yeah, he has my oldest. I don't know if I ever told y'all this, but he actually works outside. So he actually drives and all this other good stuff. So his gear is, he has a lot more gear than my youngest son does. Personal, I didn't spend anything in personal. So I should have $48 there. See how I wrote that down all confidently and don't know if I pulled something on myself. 20, 40, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I got 48 there. So that's good. Household. Can't even see. Can't see at all. Let's put stuff up because it's not like I have a lot of room. Household, I spent $7.33. And I ended last week with $22. So I either have $14 or $15. So let's say it was $14.67. So let's look up household. So 5, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. But yeah, I almost cried. I was opening the door to go up to my dental appointment, and I just heard this pop. And I looked up, I was like, oh, snap. But it didn't hurt. Which is a good thing. It's a good thing because I don't like to be in pain. Restaurants, I didn't spend anything, so I should have $40 left. Excuse me. So 20, 40. Still got that. And now the last thing is the grocery. My budget was $65 on that, and I spent $19.04 plus $35.97, so $55.01. I did pretty good. I kind of felt I did good. I know for Thanksgiving I have to buy some cheddar cheese. And I don't know why that just popped out of my head, but yep. So I either have $161 or $162 for my groceries. So let's pull this out. $120, $140. Let's pull this off. $50, $55, $56, $57, $58, $59, $60, $61, $62. So I have $162. Okay, so I'm looking at everything. And so with $162, I'm just going to set this right here for a second. And move this out of my way. With $162 and I have two more Sundays left, I have about $81 a week. So I'm going to reduce that to where the amount I can spend is $130. And I believe that's $65 a week. Let's see if my fancy math is working. Yep. So I'm going to just 130 is going to be what I can spend. And I'm going to take 20, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32. I'm going to take this 32 and just put a paperclip on it. So it can be used for next month. As far as my savings, and I can put to that. Right, so I'm going to take that. Put all of this in here. Get all that back in there. Get this out of my way. So for next week, groceries is going to be, my budget is going to be $65. Restaurants is going to be $0. Household is going to be $0. Laundry is going to be back down to $10. Personal, I'm going to say $5. I feel like there's something I want, but I don't know what it is. So I'm just going to put $5 for that. And so I'm done here. Let's get back to my calendar. I did good. I'm going to use my caffeinated Kate no spend stickers for this week. So I did go shopping on Sunday. Let me stop. I'm jumping ahead of myself, so I have to slow myself down. So put the no spend down for Monday because I didn't go anywhere on Monday. And I'm trying to match this color scheme, trying to continue it through here. So Tuesday I didn't go anywhere. And I did pay my Sprint bill. It actually came through on Friday, so $69.18, and I had deposited the $100 my son gave me. $69.18. And Wednesday, when did I go to the dentist? Whatever day it was, my jaw still hurts. I feel like I got punched in the face. I always make one of them crooked. And then Thursday, maybe that's when I went to the dentist. I think that might have been a day. But yeah, this time they had a hard time numbing my bottom area, and I kept feeling something. So I was like, oh Lord, please don't let me feel pain. But it's almost like I get a shocking cold sensation, and I don't know why. It doesn't happen all the time. But yeah, I had to get stuck like 5 different times, and I was like, oh my God. So, but I did learn my lesson, and I'm going to claim today as a no spend day because I'm not going anywhere. I got to get some studying done. I'm not on call, so I finally can just kind of relax and do what I need to do. And woohoo, I used all those stickers. I got it empty. But yeah, I got that done. I did get to meet with the lady who initially gave me my first printout of my estimates and everything. And so she was wondering what I was doing there. And so we talked about it. And then I showed her the paper. And so my visit this past Thursday did not cost me all of what I saved from my student loan payment. So what I'm going to do is make another student loan payment with the difference. Excuse me, I'm so sorry. And then she showed me how that visit did not offset the $750 that was going to go towards the visit I have to make for the implant. So the $1,500 that I set aside in my December monthly cash flow plan, that's going to be more than enough. So I'm going to keep it at $1,500 until the visit. You know, like I know I've done all 3 visits, and I'm not without funds to finish that up. And so she and I talked about it, and so I did tell her that I'm going to be doing what I can't afford to pay for, out of my paycheck. And so she was cool with that. She was just surprised that I was there. She didn't know that they changed the order of some stuff. So when she saw me there, she was looking at everything. So she redid it so that it fit the original plan as far as the cost, because the other way, it's going to cost me a little bit more because they were going to be doing a lot more work. So I go back for the implant on the 17th, and I'm guessing they got to fit everything else in between the 17th and the 31st. And so that's like three different visits. But anywho, that's the update. And I also had went ahead and got the mouthwash ahead of time, because I told her, I said, once I go home on the 17th, whatever I need, I want it at my house. I don't want to have to worry about carrying anything, dealing with anything, because I'm coming home and I know I'm going to rest. But yeah, so that's the update on all that. So everything's looking good. And so when I do the YouTube earnings video, and it should come out on Sunday, I'll be making that additional debt payment. So you're going to see it there. So that way, hopefully I don't confuse anybody. But thank y'all all so much. Let me know how your week went. How did you do? Did you overspend, underspend? And there's no shame in overspending. You know, sometimes it happens. It's not making the mistake. It's what you do afterwards. Do you just kind of keep going? Or do you just kind of course correct and make everything better? Stuff happens, right? But you guys have a super fantastic morning, afternoon, and evening. And I will talk to y'all later. Bye.